The heretic Windows wires will copy the kernel32.dll file to the Windows folder, and after that it will infect it, and after infection it will register the infected DLL file as an update. To check it that the file is infected, we will use the hex editor. Let's just check it out with this. Fine. And it will contain the following strings. I'll just search for heretic. And here it goes. Heretic in brackets by memory lapse for my toga niggas uptown baby uptown. That's the text string which will be in every infected file. Okay, let's run it. Just a message, not related with the virus. Okay, now the patch for the kernel 32 file is created, and after reboot it will be infected. To patch top it, we need any file is used. So this is the infected file, and this is the original one. So let's check it out. Okay, this is the original. Let's search. Okay, it's not found, so it's clean. And now let's find that infected one. That's the infected one. It's the kernel still. Okay, and let's search for the same string, right? And here it is, the same message, so it's infected. After reboot, that file will be replaced with the original. Actually, it's vice versa, my mistake. Okay, let's reboot. While Windows is booting up, it will start updating the original kernel file with the infected one, and that way the virus will be installed, and it will infect any portable executable PE files that are executed by appending its own code to the last section of infected files. Okay, we are back. Okay, the virus is now in the memory, and now it will infect any portable executable file if it's run. So let's check it out. We will run the hex editor first. It will be infected as long as it's run. But let's try it on something else. For example, calculator. Okay, the original size is 94.208 bytes. Let's check it in the hex editor. It's clean, but if we run it, Now it's infected. And now it's 98.304 bytes. So about 100 bytes more, if I'm not wrong. Okay, let's try to open it again in Hex Editor. Look it up, and here it is. The same string. That's pretty much about it. So whatever you run, it will be infected pretty much. So this is infected and this is infected, but I won't quite bother with that so much. Let's check the notepad. 53.248 bytes. Run, close, close. And now it's 57.344 bytes. And that's pretty much about it. The virus itself will spread on other computers by running it first. Then it will infect the kernel file. And after reboot, it will manage to spread itself on the other files. So as long as you don't reboot, on the first one, only the kernel file will be infected. That's pretty much about it. Thanks for watching and bye.